Hi, this is Jordan, and in this video I'll be sharing with you a few tips on finding and catching queen ants. So I find the best time to go out and search is during the period that ants undergo their nuptial flights. This is where winged ants, known as alates, fly off from their colony in search of alates from other colonies to mate with. This is the best opportunity you'll get in finding queens, as they'll be out in the open flying from colonies all over. So do some research and find out when nuptial flights generally occur in your region. Different ant species will fly at different times within the year. For example, here in Melbourne I find the genus Camponotus typically fly in hot summer months, Fidolae in autumn, and Eridomyrmex and Rhytida pernera in spring. Sometimes it can be hard to predict when ants will undergo this process. It is often very weather dependent. I find they favour times when it's warm and humid, so a warm day following a rainstorm is an ideal time to look. I find the key to finding queens is being very observant of what's going on around you. You want to be paying close attention to any sort of ant activity. When you see an entrance to an ant nest, take a closer look. Ants will expand their nest entrances when they're about to undergo their nuptial flights in order to make room for alates to pass through. So if you're observing a particularly small species of ant and you see a relatively large ant hill, then it could mean that they're preparing or have already begun to commence their flights. So walk around that area for a bit. If you don't find anything, come back in half an hour or so and have another look, because they might have just been on the verge of flying. Queens are often dark in colour and look larger than a typical worker ant. They tend to have a large gaster section in proportion to their body. Their movement and behaviour also differs from regular workers. They walk in a sporadic way along the ground and will often stop to investigate a patch of soil or crevice, where they'll try to dig a hole or wedge themselves into in search of an ideal nesting space where they'll begin founding their colony, laying eggs and eventually producing workers. A lot of people confuse the males with the females. Typically you can tell the males apart from the females by their size. As you can see here, males tend to be much smaller and slimmer than females. The queens will usually tear off their wings after they're done flying. And if you look closely, you can see the scars left behind where the wings used to be, just on either side of their thorax there. This is something you won't see on a regular worker ant. So if you're really unsure whether you've got a queen or not, that's a good way to find out for certain. Sometimes you'll see queens with wings still attached. These queens can be captured too, but I only suggest doing so when they're showing signs they're in search of a nesting space. If they're attempting to fly off, or you found them relatively close to a nest entrance where other winged alates are present, it's probably best just to let them be, as they likely haven't mated yet. However, it is still possible that they could be fertile. Here's a queen who decided to never shed its wings and ended up raising its first generations of workers here. Because queens are dark in colour, they stand out really well on sidewalks. So go for a walk around your block and scan the ground as you go. Most of the time you'll spot them on the ground, but it's also a good idea to look up as well, as you can occasionally see them flying around. They're not the best flyers. They travel at relatively slow speeds and in long, wide arcs, resembling that of a beetle in flight. So once you've spotted a queen, the next obvious step is to make the capture. So you want to make sure that you keep an eye on it and track its movements. A quick glance away could mean losing sight of her, so it's a good idea to be prepared and have a capturing container close to hand, or preferably on hand, to avoid fumbling around and missing the opportunity. Whenever I go out and search, I like to carry a couple of test tubes with a cotton ball as a seal. I like to lure the queens into the tubes by cupping my hand around the queen, just like this. And I just place the test tube against the end of my hand. And they typically avoid touching my hand, and instead just walk alongside it. So with a bit of luck, they end up walking straight into the tube. If you're trying to catch a stinging species like Mimesia, it's probably best to substitute your hand for something else around you, like a twig or a leaf or something, and lure them in that way. Sometimes queens can be really elusive, but it's important to keep patient and persistent. Once you've captured a queen, there's a very good chance that there's more around. The queen you captured could potentially be infertile or perhaps might not do so well in its founding stage and never end up producing workers. So don't just settle for one queen. Keep looking and capture as many as you can. It's better having more than you want than less. Most queens are fully clostral, meaning they can lay eggs and raise them up to workers before requiring any food. Surviving through this period on energy stored in fat reserves and metabolizing the wing muscles. So looking after the queens requires very little maintenance. If you're worried about having too many colonies to look after, you can always just pass them on to a friend or release them down the track. Now if you're unable to find and catch any queens during the species nuptial flights, at this point there'll be plenty of queens to be found undergoing their founding stage. I often find queens, especially of the Fidolae genus, by lifting up rocks and logs, days, weeks, and sometimes even months after their main nuptial flights. Here's a Fidolae queen I found burrowed underneath a pot plant. Just remember to be mindful when lifting things up. There might be things underneath there that don't like being disturbed. Dangerous creatures like spiders and snakes even. Here's a scorpion I encountered, and it wouldn't be hard to overlook something like this. Especially if you spotted a queen and your attention became solely focused on that. So, yeah, again, be very careful. You would not want to be stung by one of these things. So this was just a few of my tips on catching queens. Hopefully I've encouraged a few of you watching to get out there and give it a go. It may seem rather difficult at first, but with a little bit of knowledge and patience, and as long as you remember to be observant and prepared, it becomes much easier. So I hope you've enjoyed this tutorial style video. In my next one, I'll be sharing some tips on how to successfully raise up a newly caught queen. So look forward to that, and thanks for watching.